This video, we're using the fx-CG50 color graphing calculator to show you how to graph a function and then find its integral or integrals depending on, you know, the boundaries that you've chosen. So we're going to go into the graph menu. This is the main menu up here, and graph is number 5, or you can toggle to that menu icon and hit execute to enter. So we're going to first enter our function. So we're going to use a cubic function here. So 3x, we're going to raise it to the third power. And then we're going to have 6x squared subtract 2. There we go, subtract 2. Once I've entered my function, if I hit execute, that sets it. And once you've set it, now you're ready to do different things with it. So we want to actually see this graph. So we're going to hit F6 for draw. And there's our graph. And now let's say we want to find the integral between this value here and like this negative 0.8. So we're going to look for the integral functionality. And that lives in GSolve, which is above F5. So I can hit Shift F5, but since I'm in the graph and I hit F5, it automatically knows that I want to go into GSolve if I'm in the graph. So notice I'm looking for integral. I don't see it in my first set of options. That's where this arrow right here above the F6 comes into play. That means there's more. So let's hit F6, and there you'll see that my definite integral is there. So now it wants you to, what do you want to do? So we're going to do F1 again, and now it's going to ask me. So notice it's got this nice vertical green line, which is showing you my lower limit. It's telling, where do you want the lower limit? So we're going to use our toggle to kind of toggle over to where we want the lower limit. And let's say that's where we want the lower limit. So we're going to say, yes, we'd like that. So we're going to hit execute. Now that line is solid. And it gives you the values, the coordinate values at that specific point. And now it's asking, where do you want your upper limit? So let's just do this section of the graph. We're going to hit execute. And now notice that it will graph that integral between those lower and upper bounds and give me the area of that. So that's all you have to do, and you can change your integrals or do it again. So let's hit GSolve, and we're going to go back to integral. And now let's change our roots. So notice that it's got this one here already. Let's change this to include both of those curves, the one above and the one below the x-axis. Let's go in there, and now it will give us the integral there. So you can change your upper and lower bounds and look at different parts of the graph as you work. That's all there is to it. It's just using the GSolve functionality and the integral calculations and setting your lower and upper bounds.